From names carved in desks to graffiti on bathroom walls, there are a lot of ways we like to make our mark on the world. But that instinct to draw on our surroundings isn't new. Humans have been making art on cave walls for tens of thousands of years, and anthropologists can study these ancient drawings to learn a ton of cool stuff about the past. Of course, some cave art turns out to be more important than others. Some of these doodles have changed what we know about ourselves. So let's go spelunking and explore five of the coolest cave drawing sites we've ever discovered. Back in 1940, four teenagers found the entrance to a cave in southwestern France that would become one of the most significant sites for studying humans in Europe. While the exact story of how they found this cave is a bit unclear, their curiosity led them to a cavern deep underground, decorated with hundreds of spectacular paintings. The Lascaux Cave is considered one of the most important cave sites in the world, with some of the best known art from the Upper Paleolithic period between 50,000 and 12,000 years ago. Although it's a fairly small cave, its walls are covered with hundreds of prehistoric paintings, as well as around 1,400 engravings. The paintings were made in a variety of ways, from drawing, painting with brushes, and even using stencils and blowing pigment onto the wall. A lot of these paintings and carvings depict animals, and they're detailed enough that around 70% of them can be identified. There are horses, bulls, deer, bears, big cats, and more. They even painted several aurochs, a now extinct species that's thought to be the ancestor of our domesticated cows. Using carbon dating, researchers have determined that these paintings were made around 18,000 years ago. Aurochs were more common at this time, but began to peter out in the Holocene roughly 7,000 years later. So these depictions give us insight into the enigmatic species' twilight days, so to speak. Given that deep caves tend to be, well, dark, this cave also revealed how these Paleolithic painters got their work done despite the lack of sunlight. Researchers discovered evidence that deeper areas of the cave were lit with lamps, which were likely fueled by wood or animal fat. Sadly, this cave gives us a lesson in site conservation too. As word spread about the incredible artworks, tourists flocked to the region in droves. All those extra bodies produced a ton of carbon dioxide, not to mention water vapor, which fueled the growth of fungi and algae. And sadly, all that led to some major damage to these paintings, which is why it's been closed to the public for decades. Fortunately for the curious, there are excellent images of the paintings and even a recreation located right next door to the original. So the closure of this magnificent cave doesn't have to leave us in the dark. While Lascaux Cave had extinct cows, it's not the only cave that can teach us about domestic animals' wild relatives. Sulawesi is a large island of Indonesia with a history of hominin inhabitants that goes way back. As in, it's possible that another human ancestor got there before our own species did. There's archaeological evidence dated to well over 100,000 years ago, which is way earlier than modern humans hit the scene. Well, how much earlier? We don't actually know for sure. But thanks to more than 300 caves and shelters on the island that have some stellar art, researchers have gotten closer to finding out how long humans have called Sulawesi home. In 2021, researchers published their analysis of two recently discovered cave sites and estimated that the art in at least one location is at least 45,500 years old. But later work pushed that estimate even further back, all the way to over 50,000 years ago, making them some of the oldest cave drawings we've ever found. And maybe the best part of all of this is that these super old works are paintings of pigs, which is more interesting than it sounds, I promise. These cave paintings depict multiple individual pigs interacting with each other, meaning that the art is depicting a scene and implies narrative, not just an image. Specifically, we can tell these were probably Celebes warty pigs, also known as Sulawesi warty pigs. The researchers could tell these pigs were of the warty variety because, well, the artist painted in those warts. Aside from Eurasian wild boars, warty pigs are possibly the only other pig species to have been domesticated, as far as we know. And what's even wilder, these warty pigs might stand alongside wolves as the only animals that were domesticated before humans figured out agriculture. These cave paintings tell us that our species has spent a lot of time interacting with these warty pigs, and gives us an insight into the relationship before their possible domestication. So there's a lot to love about these pigs, warts and all. But before we get into our next masterpiece, here's a quick word from today's sponsor. This SciShow video is supported by Brilliant, an interactive online learning platform. There are a lot of ways to learn these days, and they all work differently. You could take a class, watch a SciShow video, or interact with a specially designed learning platform like Brilliant. Brilliant helps you solve problems and think critically, which comes in so much handier than memorizing stuff. It's like the difference between gaining wisdom and gaining knowledge. They're both good, but only one is brilliant. They get you to that next level thinking by sprinkling puzzles and quizzes throughout their lessons. And it's available to try for free at brilliant.org/scishow, the QR code on screen, or the link in the video description. You'll also get 20% off an annual premium subscription. Part of what made the Sulawesi painting special was the way that the composition suggested a story, which tells us a lot about the cognition of the people who painted them. And if that sounds impressive, wait till you hear what these next artists were up to. The Chauvet Cave was discovered by spelunkers in 1994 in the south of France, and is one of the best preserved Paleolithic cave art sites known. The art in these caves dates to more than 30,000 years ago. The paintings depict several species of animals in all sorts of expressive, complex scenes. There are dozens of animals in these scenes, some of which were done in multiple sessions, with artists returning back to add more to the image. But there's one other thing that sets these images apart. The paintings just might be our species' first attempt at animation. It's been argued that the superimposed animal outlines were deliberately drawn so the animals would appear to move in flickering flame light, and the evidence is pretty compelling. For example, in one of the paintings, an eight-legged bison looks to be actually demonstrating a four-legged animal just in two different stages of running. So, as the firelight would dance along the walls, it's thought that different parts of the image would be emphasized, creating the appearance of a moving image. To be clear, it's pretty challenging to confirm the intentions of artists from tens of thousands of years ago, given that we can't, like, ask them, but whether intentional or not, the effect is jaw-dropping. It's nice to imagine a bunch of early humans gathered around the fire watching their favorite rerun. I wonder what their go-to movie snack was. Our next cave masterpiece takes us down under to Australia. The rock formation known as Unbungbung Gallery in Kakadu National Park is one of the most visited Aboriginal heritage sites in Australia. Hi, Savannah from Later in Production here. We learned that the Australian government has some restrictions for showing images of the Unbungbung Gallery in external media. That is honestly a good thing overall because it protects the interests of the First Nations people of Australia. But unfortunately, because we were not able to get in touch with anybody from Kakadu by the time we published this video, we were not able to include any images in the video. If you'd like to see the art itself, there are images available elsewhere online. We've linked to some in the description of this video. Rock art isn't a rare sight in Kakadu, with thousands of rock art sites found within the park boundaries. But unlike the other examples we've covered so far, in the case of Unbungbung, we're not left to wonder exactly what the creators were thinking about when they made these artworks. We can ask traditional knowledge keepers about the meanings behind the pieces, because some of them are still alive today. Some of the most famous works of rock art in the area were painted as recently as 1963 or 1964, but that doesn't mean that the rock art of Kakadu is all modern. Some of the oldest surviving art in the region is likely more than 12,000 years old and might be as old as 30,000. Because a lot of the newer art was painted over older images, it's hard to know exactly when some of the earliest pieces were made. But it does appear that art was being created at this location for at least the last 4,000 years and likely longer, which is why some people call this the world's longest continuing art tradition. It's not common to have discussions with people in a tradition like that firsthand, so it's pretty neat that this is actually possible in the case of Kakadu, and through asking those who were alive during these periods of rock art creation, it's understood that creating rock art was not only a part of daily life, but a collaborative effort too. The area surrounding Unbungbung Gallery within Kakadu Park was an important area for many clans in the region. They'd meet here to share their knowledge, stories, and even pass down their painting techniques to the younger generation. Many pieces were collaboratively made, which also suggests that earlier pieces would have been group efforts too. Being able to talk to modern practitioners of such an ancient tradition can help us understand more of the thoughts and intentions behind these pieces of ancient art. So when you marvel at these iconic cave paintings, remember to think about the artist or artists behind them too. Our final work of art in this collection is some of the newest of the bunch, but its subject is the oldest by 200 million years. Located in South Africa, the art itself is young, dating to about 200 years ago, between 1800 1821 and 1835. This particular art was painted by the San people, hunter-gatherers who occupied a huge area of southern Africa until the mid-19th century, when they were almost entirely displaced, enslaved, or killed by white colonizers. While this site is called the Brakfontein Cave, we have to admit it isn't technically a cave, more like an overhang. At this site, there are paintings of a wide range of animals, including antelope and aardvark, and even depictions of some battle scenes. But one particular image has gotten a lot of attention. The animal depicted is strange and doesn't really look like anything we'd see in that area today. The detail in the painting is impressive, a long animal covered in dotted skin with what look like two long tusks on the face. Most of the San art depictions are based on real animals from their environments, but this one doesn't appear to match anything that would have been living at the same time as the San. It turns out that's because it might be their interpretation of an extinct animal. This particular area is home to a lot of fossils, so it's very reasonable to assume they had been coming across them from time to time when erosion or some other process brought them to the surface. There's evidence that the San would collect these fossils, transporting them over long distances. And one fossil that shows up a lot in this area is a dicynodont, a group of tusked herbivorous mammal relatives that lived from about 270 million years ago until roughly 200 million years ago. With this fossil connection in mind, the spotted body of the animal painting resembles the dicynodont's bumpy skin texture that is visible in some fossils. Plus, in all other San imagery, any tusks depicted are turned upwards, like in warthogs and bush pigs, which they also painted and would have encountered themselves. So the downward tusk shape also lined up with those of the fossilized animal. The authors of this paper even noted that the shape of the animal in the painting is remarkably similar to a so-called death pose, which is the way that some animals' bodies curl backwards after they die. If the inspiration for the artwork was a fossil, that would explain the unusual pose. The painting was done at least a decade before scientists had even formally defined or identified this dicynodont species, leading some researchers to say that it's the earliest depiction of this particular fossilized animal. And this image isn't the only compelling evidence of early paleontological interests of the San in Africa. In Mokali Cave in Lesotho, early San artists painted a footprint from a type of dinosaur called an ornithopod, and a few depictions of the animals themselves standing upright on two legs. What's wild about the footprint image is that if it's as old as the researchers suspect, it would be the first depiction of a fossilized dinosaur footprint by any human ever. And those standing figures of the dinosaurs show that the San may have been better at reconstructing their behaviors than early European researchers. A later reconstruction of ornithopods that was on display at the Crystal Palace in London showed their subjects as quadrupeds, not bipeds, as the San painted them. But we now think that the vast majority of all ornithopod species were bipedal, which means that the San got it right. It's possible that the San's experience as expert trackers of living animals helped them interpret fossil evidence of dead ones. Sadly, the paintings themselves are in bad condition, as their position near the mouth of the cave has resulted in a fair bit of damage over the years. But between these two sites, it's fair to say that the San people have been doing paleo art since before it was cool. So all of these early artists had something really cool to share about their world and the way that they understood it. From warty pigs and beefy bovines to literal fossils, there's a lot to unpack from these works of art. And who knows, maybe that doodle you made on the bathroom wall might tell future anthropologists all about you too.